Join us for the last of our Mondulkiri series through the back roads of Mondulkiri province, where we discover one of the most incredible waterfalls in the country, camp through another storm by stunning waterholes, climb Panyom Namlir with seven of our new best friends,
Chunyang,
and discover more hidden gems. There's much more to Mondulkiri than the capital San Monorom, so come with us to see some of the highlights. We start this episode at Do Cramon Mountain on the northern side of San Monorom, before heading east towards Panyom Namlir Wildlife Sanctuary. We checked out some of the sites along the way, including Natural Swimming Pool and Ooflai Waterfall, both of which were too full to swim at, before stopping at Busra Waterfall.
Pay an entry fee.
So, we've pulled up at Busra Waterfall, and we can hear it. In. More money. Surely not.
That's a win.
So, sign said 250 entry for foreigners and we got it free. Maybe because it's a Friday. Maybe she's just feeling generous.
Usual markets at the entry to every major waterfall. So it's a day. Goodbye. Sucks a bay.
Looks like this is just the top of it. Looks like it's a pebble here, it comes over here. And there's another waterfall down there.
Yeah.
It's a lot of stairs down.
Insane. It's gonna look
even better from that platform anyway.
How good. Huge waterfall there. An even bigger one there. It's crazy.
Thank you.
all's done. Now to the ethnic cultural centre village.
Yeah, the last little thing to tick off in this area.
Looks like a traditional house. Oh, it's nice and cool in here.
Bit of a difference to outside.
Pretty amazing build.
Little hook-up door.
All bamboo. And this looks like the stuff that like our watch and ring and stuff was made out of.
Yeah, it would be.
Or like cut down real fine.
Yeah, they do fine layers and they do thicker ones on top and up.
Or the walls are made out of the thicker stuff.
Same way.
Small little rooms, elevated up.
Beautiful. Got gardens, banana trees. That is Busra Waterfall, done and dusted. Just bought some local passion fruit wine on the way out. And now we're gonna go find a camp. And the spot that we're gonna aim for is like a waterfall half an hour from here. So we'll see how long it actually takes and whether the tracks exist. Back off road. I'm gonna slide in. I feel like we say this a lot, but I don't think many cars come down here. It's only scooter tracks. Alright, it's getting a bit skinny. But there was a sign and it did have a picture of a car coming down here, so that gives me hope.
Half an hour drive, they said.
Half hour.
Should be right.
Yeah. I just said on the sign there's some more rivers and we're in a wet season, so better look. You see that's sloppy on that side. That's a vertical wall and this is choppy and there's nowhere to winch off. Like that's just... If we weren't so far away from anywhere... But I don't know if that's worth the risk.
because if we do drop in,
if we do drop in there, we're not reversing out of there and we can't winch backwards. We have to do a full
forwards.
We have to do a full send forwards.
Some not when rocks. There's a new weird sound coming from underneath the car.
And there's a road that goes back that way, so
yeah,
we'll turn around and see if we can get around another way.
Says we've arrived at the waterfall.
I can hear it.
This bit sort of looks swimmable.
Well, we've been here about 15 minutes
and that's camp all set up. Pretty much. It's still very sunny. And it doesn't really feel like rain, but once bitten, twice shy. So, setting everything up with the walls. Just in case. Still pretty early. Might go for a little dip. After that's all tied down. I'm sweating.
Same.
Somebody call Barry. Yes. Brown, murky and cold. That's so good. After setting up that camp.
All right, swim's all done. We're nice and refreshed. Clouds are coming in, so we better go. We better go set up the rest of our camp, get a fire going before we get wet.
We are all packed up and just left camp. First on the agenda for today is another waterfall called Leng Pel Waterfall. That's about 2 km away, I reckon. As usual, we'll see how we actually go with the tracks, but looks pretty well cut in. And then after that, we are going to go to Nemlia Mountain, which is the big stone mountain, and we're going to climb that. Last night was pretty nice at camp.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Paul didn't have a good sleep because we're on doxies, because there's malaria around here and they're renowned for giving you strange dreams.
Yes, many. Many strange dreams.
Yeah. But one of the few camps where we haven't seen anyone our whole stay here. So, really, really nice. I don't think we got too far to go.
No, it says to go straight up that hill.
Oh, yes. That could be interesting.
The locals are hooting. What's he doing?
About 800 meters from this waterfall.
From the end of the road.
Yeah. Maybe.
Oh yeah, we'll walk. Let's see what happens.
Quite looks like you can get through on satellite, but who knows? Well, Leng Pel Waterfall, chalked up as another L for exploring in Cambodia. Jungle's too thick. We found one track that I think went there, but it was just a massive bog hole.
It looked a bit tight. It was like a track to track.
Yeah. Unknown depth, but it looked deep.
And tight.
So, all good. We're,
This is one of the tractors up here, though.
Yeah.
Go down that track.
Yeah. We should have said we wanted to go to Leng Pel Waterfall. Jumped on the back of the tractor. So we've made it to Namlia Mountain and we've got some followers. Local guides maybe? Oh, this is a big bastard mountain.
Big rocks.
Kanak chamua bay?
Chamua. Rotana.
Rotana?
Rotana.
Rotana.
Ochalam chamu suwani.
Nyom chamu kalia.
Rotana. Aku chamu. Nyom chamu rotana.
Kot chamu pol.
Chamu pol.
Pol.
Pol. Pol.
Guess then we go this way.
Swim in the river after.
Yeah. This is very steep. And we've got 6-7 guides from B.
Got a heart rate going already.
Steep.
It's very steep. Yeah. Bloody. Well, that sort of seems like the worst of it done. But we're not at the top yet.
Still surrounded by very happy children.
Hey, my turn.
First time trying barbecue shapes. Chen Yang?
Chen.
I think they're excited about the drone.
There's a life I lead in this city, hurrying to cup my teeth. I can take what I need to get by, it doesn't make it easy. The other piece of my heart moves slow.
Back down we go when I return from the with our merry band of children. Lily. And not interested in us anymore.
Nah.
How's that?
That's good. Stinger hot going up. Cool up top, hot on the way down.
Yeah. Might have some lunch. And then hit the road. So we had some lunch at Phnom Nam Lir. And we're just heading back through the rubber plantations now, back to San Modorom. We're gonna grab some water and then head down towards Dok Dam. And yeah, I do have another drop in for a waterfall down that way. So maybe we can camp there.
Sweet, fingers crossed.
Arrived at Tre Tom Waterfall. And I reckon we're gonna be able to camp here. It's pretty nice. You do like a water crossing, like over the top of the waterfall.
The Google reviews did say this was a hidden gem. Infrastructure's seen better days. See how slippery this is in puddles. Jesus. Very is the answer.
Across the river.
I could see the waterfall, but I didn't realise it was that
big. Side quest.
After a bit of deliberation, we've settled on this patch as a camp spot.
I'm guessing you can camp here since there's that many huts around. And to add to the excitement, the thunder is rumbling. Early afternoon storm today. It's only just after 3.
I think that was probably a record setup pace for this setup. Not that we've done it that many times, to be fair. But
rain's just starting now. Got a little fly going. Crack a beer.
While Paul's getting that fly going, I go for a little walk down to this river crossing. I think this is going to be the spot to go for a swim. There was one of the local guys washing his bike in the crossing as we came over.
So this is the top of that massive waterfall we just walked down through before.
Well, rain has well and truly set in now.
Father got a flyer?
We had a little splash in the river.
Nice little swim.
I've got clean dry clothes on. You've got pants.
Pants and socks.
Less socially acceptable for me to do that here. And yeah, we don't really have anything set up.
Ah, Jesus! What?
Paul's getting bitten by many ants.
Oh, through the socks.
So aside from the mosquitoes when we first arrived, and now the ants, this spot is lovely.
Oh, matchy matchy.
We're always matchy.
Turn around. Fangirl.
Number one fan.
Yeah. Have you done a morning intro?
No.
Good morning from a waterfall called
Tray Tom.
It's
near Dok Dam, which is near the Vietnam border in Mondulkiri.
Yeah, I had a beautiful sleep last night.
Yeah.
And just the sound of the waterfall, a little bit of rain.
Yeah.
No music for once.
Magic. Just a few scooters cruising past, looking confused.
Yep. Very confused.
Until we wave and say hello, and then they usually smile and wave back.
Oh, yeah, we've woken up, had a coffee, bagels are chopped up, fire's going.
Probably need flipping.
Hash browns on the fire.
Perfect.
All right, less distractions, more not burning and overboiling stuff.
Brushing. So, we're all packed up. Paul's had a dip. We're gonna hit the Frog and Toad, and the plan for today is we're gonna do a little bit of exploring around here because it looks like there's a few random tracks that follow the river, maybe some other four-wheel drive tracks that go down towards the Vietnam border. But we'll see how maintained or otherwise they are. That's just from Gly Maps. And then I think there's a couple more lookouts, according to Google, a bit further south. So we'll go have a look at those. And then we'll probably start tracking home this afternoon. But in the meantime, I'm going to try some of these bonus lines near our camp. They look very rotted out. A fun little bit of exploring around camp, but didn't find too much. A lot of roads being developed, land cleared, probably building more guest houses and that sort of thing along here. Now we might track it back to the main road and head south and check out those lookouts that are a bit closer to the Vietnam border, just south of Dock Darm. Yeah. cool?
Yeah.
We finish this episode atop Phnom and Dong Snay, just a few kilometres from the Doc Dam Vietnam border. We hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please give this video a like and make sure you've subscribed so you don't miss any videos exploring off Cambodia's tourist trail.
B-roll.
It's not B-roll anymore. It's outtakes.